Welcome to Orisole Solutions. In this session, let's talk about pharmacovigilance. For a better understanding of pharmacovigilance, the knowledge in clinical research and clinical trials are necessary. The detailed explanation of clinical research and clinical trial phases are explained in the video. The link is given in the description. Let us see the drug development and approval process in a nutshell. It starts with preclinical trials, clinical research, data analysis, and post-marketing surveillance. In preclinical trials, the laboratory synthesis of the molecule will be done, then the research protocol is prepared, and the drug is tested on the animals. The data from the preclinical trials is sent to the regulatory authority for review. If the regulatory authority gives the approval for the trials in the human beings, then clinical trials in human beings will start. In phase 1 trials, the dose-finding assessment of the drug or therapy is done in 2200 healthy human volunteers. Then the drug enters into phase 2 trials. In phase 2 trials, the testing of beneficial effects and undesirable effects are identified in 100 plus patients. Then the drug enters into phase 3. In phase 3, the comparison of new therapy with standard therapy will be done. The phase 3 trials are conducted in multiple locations throughout the world in thousands of patient population. All the data from clinical trials will be biostatistically analyzed, and the significant results were sent to regulatory for new drug application. The regulatory authority will review the data. If the regulatory authority gives the approval, then the drug will enter into the market. After the drug enters into the market, the phase 4 trials or the post-marketing surveillance will be done. You may get a doubt, like, where is pharmacovigilance in entire process? So wherever the adverse drug reactions or adverse events occur, there the pharmacovigilance plays a vital role. Now let us see the definition of pharmacovigilance. According to World Health Organization, the definition of pharmacovigilance is the science and activities related to the detection, assessment, understanding, and prevention of adverse effects or any other drug-related problems. The role of pharmacovigilance is they receive the information data from patients and healthcare providers via pharmacovigilance agreements as well as other sources such as medical literature. Pharmacovigilance is mainly concerned with identifying the hazards associated with pharmaceutical products and minimizing the risk of any harm that may come to patients. Now let us see the historical background and evolution of pharmacovigilance. Between 1934 and 1960, the period is called the period of drug explosion. Let us see various events during this period. In the United States of America, diethylene glycol, DEG, is mistakenly used to solubilize sulfonamide. As a result, 107 people died. In 1956, thalidomide was launched into the market in 46 countries. Thalidomide is mainly used by pregnant women for morning sickness. Between 1959 and 1961, around 20,000 cases were reported with fetal abnormalities, maximum cases in Germany. This is called thalidomide disaster, detected in 1961. So thalidomide induced teratogenicity, that is phocomelia in newborn babies. Because of that, in 1962, United States of America revised law requiring to prove safety and efficacy before issuing marketing authorization. In 1963, British Committee on Safety of Drug Monitoring was introduced. In 1964, United Kingdom started yellow card system. Between 1964 and 1965, national ADR reporting systems were introduced in Australia, New Zealand, Canada, West Germany, Sweden, etc. In 1978, WHO moved from Geneva to Uppsala. World Health Organization established its program for international drug monitoring in response to the thalidomide disaster detected in 1961. Together with the World Health Organization Collaborating Center for International Drug Monitoring, Uppsala, World Health Organization promotes pharmacovigilance at the country level. At the end of 2010, 134 countries were part of World Health Organization Pharmacovigilance Program. These are the drugs withdrawn from the market as a result of adverse effects. The examples are thalidomide, benoxoprofen, fenfluramine, estimazole, phenylpropylamine, cervistatin, cisapride, roficoxib, clobutinol, etc. Each and every drug has a different adverse effect. Because of that, these drugs were withdrawn from the market. So what is the aim of pharmacovigilance? Early detection of unknown safety problems, identification of risk factors, quantifying risks, preventing patients from being affected unnecessarily, to enhance patient care and patient safety in relation to the use of medicines, to support public health programs by providing reliable, balanced information for effective assessment of the risk-benefit profile of medicines. What is the need of pharmacovigilance? The safety data from clinical trials is insufficient. The tests conducted in animals are insufficient to predict human safety. Safety profile in special groups are inadequate or incomplete. The medicines are supposed to save lives. Dying from a disease is sometimes unavoidable. Dying from a medicine is unacceptable. So ADRS are expensive. They may be life-consuming or life-threatening. For promoting rational use of medicines and adherence, the pharmacovigilance is necessary. Now let us see the stakeholders in pharmacovigilance. World Health Organization, governments of different countries, industries, hospitals, clinicians, nurses, paramedics, academia, pharmacists, patients and their relatives. These are the people who are responsible for pharmacovigilance. Now let us see the reporting time frame of adverse drug reactions. So the expedited reporting is required as soon as possible. Non-serious ADRs are not reported on an expedited basis. They are included in the periodic safety update report. But serious unexpected ADRs are to be reported within 15 calendar days. Serious death or life-threatening ADRs should be reported within 7 calendar days. This is the governing structure of pharmacovigilance in India. National Pharmacovigilance Program of India. It's under Central Drug Standard Control Organization, under the Minister of Health and Family Welfare. It will get the ADRs from ADR monitoring centers like medical institutes, research institutes, CROs, etc. through journal and subjournal centers. It has different departments like reviewing panel, strategic advisory committee, steering committee. They will analyze the ADRs and they take the necessary actions on the stakeholders. This is the formal ADR reporting form in India. So ADR reporting form may be different in different countries according to their specifications. Now let us see few terminologies in pharmacovigilance and their definitions. Adverse effect, any undesirable or unintended consequence of drug administration. Adverse drug event, any untoward medical occurrence that may present during the treatment with a medicine, but which does not necessarily have a causal relationship with the treatment. Adverse drug reaction, any noxious change which is suspected to be due to a drug, occurs at doses normally used in humans, requires treatment or decrease in dose, or indicates caution in future use of the same drug. Signal is defined as reported information on a possible causal relationship between an adverse event and a drug, the relationship being unknown or incompletely documented previously. Medication error is defined as any preventable event that may cause or lead to inappropriate medication use or patient harm while the medication is in control of the healthcare professional, patient or consumers. Serious drug reaction, an adverse drug reaction that may leading to death or life-threatening or hospitalization, persistent or permanent disability, congenital anomaly, or it requires intervention to prevent permanent impairment or damage is called serious adverse drug reaction. So these are various terminologies and definitions. Now let us see various steps in pharmacovigilance. Safety data management, signal detection for any new altered safety issue, signal evaluation and making decisions with regard to safety issues, actions including regulatory to protect public health. Informing all concerned parties or stakeholders. So the steps also may differ in different countries or different companies based on their specifications and requirements. Let us see the methods for collecting adverse drug reactions or AEs. In active surveillance, site surveillance like hospitals, pharmacies, nursing homes, etc. Focused ADR monitoring of drugs, prescription event monitoring, disease registries from health, healthcare programs, etc. The comparative observational studies are cross-sectional survey, case control study, coherent studies, large safety trials, drug utilization studies. These are the methods used for collecting AEs or ADRs. Now let us see international collaboration in pharmacovigilance. The Council for International Organization of Medical Sciences, CIOMS, International Conference on Harmonization, the International Society of Pharmacovigilance, ISOP, World Health Organization, International Drug Monitoring, Uppsala, WHO, UMC. Now let us see the scenario of pharmacovigilance in India. Before 1986, there is no ADR monitoring system in India. In 1986, ADR monitoring system in India first proposed with 12 regional centers. In 1997, India joined WHO ADR monitoring program with 3 centers. Between 2004 and 2008, National Pharmacovigilance Program with 2 journal centers, 5 regional centers and 24 peripheral centers were established in India. In 2010, Pharmacovigilance Program of India, PVPI, was launched in July. So the goal is to ensure that the benefits of use of medicine outweighs the risks and the safeguard the health of the Indian population. So why pharmacovigilance is so important in clinical research? To find out unexpected adverse drug reactions, drug-drug interactions and drug-food interactions, to find out risk factors, to increase the quality of life, to find out long-term efficacy of drugs, and to find out the cost assessment of the drugs. So what is the importance of implementing pharmacovigilance? The effect of medicine might be affected by presence of many different diseases, drugs, diets, traditional and herbal remedies. It is essential that a monitoring system for the safety of medicines is supported by doctors, pharmacists, nurses and other healthcare professionals in the country to prevent unnecessary suffering by patients and financial loss. So adverse drug reactions should be reported on daily basis through drug regulatory authorities, National Pharmacovigilance Program. Systematic safety monitoring is needed to identify previous recognized and unrecognized adverse drug reactions of medicines in the post-marketing period. Post-marketing surveillance involves ongoing process of risk identification, risk assessment, and risk mitigation. The goal is always the accurate assessment of the benefit versus the risk of the product in the population who receive it. This is the introduction of pharmacovigilance, so this may help to the people who enter into the pharmacovigilance domain. Now let us see the educational requirements for the candidates who want to enter into pharmacovigilance domain. So bachelor's or master's in pharmacy, that is B pharmacy or M pharmacy, doctor of pharmacy, pharma D, master's in life sciences, MSc, medicine, MBBS, PGs, dental, BDS, MDS. Apart from that, the computer knowledge, that is MS Office, Word, MS Excel, etc. are also needed. So based on the qualification and experience, the pharmacovigilance will have different roles and responsibilities. So what are the skills required for the candidates who want to enter into pharmacovigilance domain? The knowledge in clinical trials and clinical research, clinical trial regulations such as FDA, EMA, DCGI, etc. Pharmacovigilance programs in different countries, knowledge in ICH, GCP, good communication skills, good computer skills, good leadership skills, problem solving skills, time management skills, etc. are also needed. So these are the top companies offering pharmacovigilance jobs in India as well as around the globe. I could mention only few, but there are more companies which are offering pharmacovigilance jobs. So why one should choose career in pharmacovigilance? Global opportunities, lucrative salaries, flexibility in working hours as well as location, consistent growth, more openings for freshers, etc. This is the total introduction of pharmacovigilance, various departments, the need, importance, as well as the process of pharmacovigilance. If you feel this video is informative, please like the video. Please comment your questions, queries, and doubts. Please share this video with your friends. For more updates and information, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching the video. Have a great day and have a great future ahead.